So a lot of you guys are familiar with spindle spacers, right? We've got a whole bunch of them on either side of this crank, and that's because it's one of these newer style cranks that have a very long spindle format, but it has a very narrow bottom bracket, which is based on the old, well, the old threaded bottom brackets. I have one right here. This is what you would essentially be welding inside of a frame if you wanted to make a BSA threaded aluminum bike frame shell, and you can see how that fits right there. Okay, so this is what they used, and they based BB30 on this, except they just machined out the shell and then they press bearings directly in there. Now this is a sort of a problem here, because now you have this really long spindle and you need to put all these spacers in there. It's kind of like headset spacers. It's not necessarily wrong, but it can be a little unsightly if you ask me. But the biggest problem is it creates a cantilever effect on the bearings. In other words, the bearings are way inboard, but the moments of stress are way out here, okay? So Shimano a long time ago corrected this when they came out with the Holotech 2, because this is that same threaded shell I showed you a second ago, but with two cups in it. And you can see already where this math is going, right? Look at this. Here's a spacer. See that? See where this math is going? It's all based on that old Holotech system. All right. So instead of having a huge stack of spacers, the way to do it is to start out with a bottom bracket that's already wide enough to position the bearings outside the frame once it is installed. So this is what we're gonna do right now, because we wanna reduce that cantilever effect. We wanna support the crank outboard as much as possible by journaling the bearings as far out as we can. And that's what we're gonna do right now. So we've installed our wide format BB30 bottom bracket. And if you come up here, you can see that now the bearings are actually journaling the crank outside of the frame. So we've gone from this situation where the bearings were inside of the frame to more like this situation, like with a Holotech crank where the bearings are outside, they're journaling the bearings out here. We have gotten rid of that cantilever effect. And what this has done is increased the stiffness and the durability of this bottom bracket.